Before we wrap up, let's go over some assumptions and restrictions for chi-square tests. Just like with all tests, we have to make sure that we're adhering to certain guidelines in order to do this test. First of all, we have to avoid dependent observations. In the case of the Loftus and Palmer study, the car crash one, independence would be violated if the participants contributed to data in more than just one of these cells. For example, if they were asked both how fast were the cars going when they smashed into each other and how fast were the cars going when they hit each other. In other words, these 16 participants are totally different from all of these other participants whose data is in the other cells. Another thing we should do is avoid small expected frequencies, and in general have a large number of participants. Remember that our chi-squared statistic is just based off the sample. We have a sample of observations and corresponding expected values. If we were to use this chi-squared statistic to make inferences about the population that this sample is from, then the total number of participants should be at least 20, and a conservative rule of thumb specifies that each expected cell frequency should be at least 5. Recall that in our examples, the observed and expected values were the observed and expected frequencies.